हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम अमित कुमार यादव फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल डिपार्टमेंट SIIT कॉलेज भोपाल। टुडे इन द BEEE सब्जेक्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस लॉसेस इन द ट्रांसफार्मर। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। एज यू नो दैट इन अ सिंगल फेज ट्रांसफार्मर देर आर बेसिकली टू टाइप्स ऑफ पावर लॉसेस। फर्स्ट वन इज कोर लॉस, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज आयरन लॉस, एंड सेकेंड वन इज कॉपर लॉसेस। ओके, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट फ्रॉम कोर लॉस। As its name suggests, this is a core loss. It means these losses occur in the core of the transformer. In the core loss, we can also divide this core loss into two parts. First one is hysteresis loss and second one is eddy current loss. So let us start. Now, before understanding the eddy current loss, we have to first understand what is eddy current. So what is eddy current? As you know that when you supply current and when we supply voltage in the primary winding, a current flow start flowing in the primary winding, due to which a flux induced in the primary winding, and some part of that primary winding flux linked with the core. And as you know that the core have a circular closed path, that's why a small amount of flux start flowing in the core. Now, due to the flux flowing in the core, a very small amount of current start flowing in the core. Why current start flowing in the core? Because the core has a closed loop connection. That's why due to flux, a very small amount of current start flowing in the core of the current. That current is called as eddy current. And because of that eddy current, power is lost in the core in the form of heat. Okay, so what is eddy current loss? Eddy current loss, the formula for the eddy current loss can be explained as this is also denoted as capital P suffix mein E. So P equals to KE F square BM square T square V watt, where this K is constant, V is volume of core, T is thickness of the lamination, F is frequency of the flux, BM is the maximum flux density. Okay, so these losses are mainly consist of hysteresis and eddy current losses occurring in the transformer core due to alternating flux. These are also called as constant losses because the flux in the core remain constant and does not depend on the load. So these losses can be determined by open circuit test. Already we have discussed that by using this open circuit test, we just find out the core losses. Now second one is hysteresis loss. What is hysteresis loss? As already we have discussed, when we magnetize or demagnetize the core of a transformer again and again, then what happens? Due to regular magnetization and demagnetization, it causes some retentivity in the core of the transformer. Okay, means when you switch off the transformer, still some magnetizing effect are present in the core. That's losses due to this property. Some losses occur in the transformer. Okay, so this is your hysteresis loss. Now this hysteresis loss is denoted by PH. It is equals to KHF BM to the power 1.6 small V watt, where this V is volume of the core, KI is again a constant, T is thickness of the lamination, F is frequency of the flux, BM equals to flux density. Hysteresis loss can be minimized by using steel of high silicon content, whereas eddy current loss can be reduced by using core of thin lamination. अगर हमें एडी हिस्टेरेसिस करंट लॉस को रिड्यूस करना है तो हमें कोर ट्रांसफार्मर का जो कोर है उसमें स्टील कंटेंट को बढ़ाना पड़ेगा। साथ ही साथ अगर हमें एडी करंट को रिड्यूस करना है तो हमें कोर में हम जो लेमिनेशन करेंगे, ओके, अपन को मालूम है कि कोर की जो प्लेटें हैं थिन प्लेटों से आपस में कंबाइन होती हैं, बट हर प्लेट आपस में इंसुलेटेड होता है। तो अगर हमें एडी करंट लॉस को रिड्यूस करना है तो हमें यह ध्यान रखना होगा कि हमें ये जो लेमिनेशन है इनको काफ़ी थिन रखना होगा, ओके। बाई यूजिंग दीज टू वेज वी कैन रिड्यूस द कोर लॉस ऑफ द ट्रांसफॉर्मर। नाउ सेकेंड वन इज कॉपर लॉस। वॉट इज कॉपर लॉस? आई थिंक यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट वॉट इज कॉपर लॉस। बेसिकली दिस लॉस is caused due to resistance property of the conducting material, okay. So these losses are in both primary and secondary winding due to their ohmic resistance. These losses can be determined by short circuit test, and the total copper loss of a transformer is copper loss due to primary winding plus copper loss due to secondary winding. Here this PC equals to I1 square R1. What is this I1? I1 is your primary current. What is this R1? R1 is your resistance of your primary winding. Okay. And now what is this I2? I2 is your secondary current. And what is R2? R2 is the resistance of the secondary winding. So by adding the I square R of primary and secondary winding, we can easily calculate the total copper loss of the transformer. Now these losses are also called as variable loss because the losses vary as the square of the load current. अपन ने अभी पहले भी डिस्कस किया कोर लॉसेस फिक्स हो हैं। क्यों फिक्स है? क्योंकि कोर में फ्लो होने वाला फ्लक्स फिक्स है और उस फ्लक्स की वजह से एडी करंट और हिस्टेरेसिस लॉसेस प्रोड्यूस होते हैं, इस वजह से उनकी वैल्यू भी फिक्स होती है। बट कॉपर लॉस फिक्स नहीं होता, इस लॉस को हम वेरिएबल लॉस भी बोलते हैं। क्यों बोलते हैं? क्योंकि जितना ज़्यादा हम लोड बढ़ाएंगे क्या होगा, उससे उतना ज़्यादा लोड को करंट चाहिए होगा, उससे क्या होगा, सेकेंडरी करंट बढ़ेगा, और जब सेकेंडरी करंट बढ़ेगा तो ऑब्वियसली प्राइमरी करंट भी बढ़ेगा। तो जैसे जैसे लोड बढ़ेगा कॉपर लॉस बढ़ेगा, इसीलिए इस लॉस को हम वेरिएबल लॉस बोलते हैं। सो यहाँ से हम ये बोल सकते हैं कि टोटल लॉस ऑफ एनी ट्रांसफॉर्मर, ओके, इज बेसिकली समेशन ऑफ कोर लॉस पी आई प्लस कॉपर लॉस पी सी। ओके, थैंक यू।